You know, there's been literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of minor pro teams who have skated in North American rinks, but this team stands out because not only it has a great legacy, a great tradition, some of the big links of the NHL came through this community. Now, New York State is considered one of the best minor pro locations for every major sport in North America, including baseball and even football at times. But today we're going to be talking about a squad that is still remains at the end, in the deep in the hearts of New York State hockey fans, the Clinton Comets. Now, they were based in Clinton, New York, started off in 1927 as the Clinton Hockey Club and nicknamed the Comets in 1949. The team played primarily at the Clinton Arena from 1949 until 1973. The team was originally started by Ed Stanley, who acted as manager to build a team from local high school students and helped to provide finances for the squad to buy equipment and take road trips. He quickly was able to build a very successful team, which in the 1934 season played in the National Amateur Championships at Madison Square Garden against, of all squads, the Hershey Bears. Stanley, along with Albert I. Prettyman, who brought college hockey to nearby Hamilton College, went on to be the only two people from the same town or city on the 1940 Olympic Hockey Committee. Of course, the Winter Olympics were scheduled in Sapporo, but were canceled because of the start of World War II, as well as the hopes of Comets players William Gehring and Eric Schoons, who were trying out for the Olympic team. Now, from 1954 until 1973, the Comets were enrolled in the Eastern Hockey League. They dominated for 10 of their 19 seasons. Most notably, under the head coach Pat Kelly, the Comets posted a 315-208-64 win-loss tie record over 8 seasons. Now, during that period, and especially the 68 season, the Comets produced impressive records. Now, that 68 campaign is considered by many one of the best professional records of all time. They finished the season, ladies and gentlemen, 57-5-10. Only lost 5 of 72 games. Now, they won the EHL playoff crown in 1959, 64, and from 68 to 1970 inclusive. Now, later when the team played games at the Unicum Memorial Auditorium, it changed its name to the Mohawk Valley Comets and played in the North American Hockey League. Now, key players on the squad included the great Eddie Jackman, a Hockey Hall of Fame goalie with the New York Rangers, Benny Woit, a former player for the Red Wings, the great Pete Babando, a former player for Detroit Red Wings, Boston Bruins, and Chicago Blackhawks. Now, Pat Kelly also went on later to become the head coach of the Colorado Rockies, was the founder and first league commissioner of the East Coast Hockey League, and he also had an ECHL Champions Trophy named after him, the Kelly Cup. Now, Len Speck also played for the team from 61 to 71, a very well-respected skater. Now, Jack Timmons, who was player coach from 54 to 58, went on to become general manager of the Tidewater Red Wings, Detroit's American League affiliate. He was also commissioner of the North American Hockey League and retired recently from the National Hockey League Central Scouting Service. Now, Jack Kane, who went on to get included with the Greater Utica Sports Hall of Fame in 97, was a Clinton alumni. Now, other hockey teams in the Mohawk Valley are quite diverse. The Utica Mohawks, again, of the EHL, 78-80. The Mohawk Valley Stars of the Atlantic Coast Hockey League, 81-84. The Mohawk Valley Comets of the Atlantic Coast Hockey League, 85-87. The Utica Devils of the AHL, 87-93. Utica Bulldogs of the Colonial Hockey League, 93-94. The Utica Blizzard of the Colonial Hockey League, 94-97. The Mohawk Valley Prowlers of the United Hockey League between 98 and 2001. The Mohawk Valley Ice Cats of the Northeastern Hockey League, 06-07. And the Utica Comets of the American Hockey League, of course, from 2013 to the present day. Now, the full details or statistical details on the Comets are available at the Internet Hockey Database. Again, do the search on that. Gives you a list of the alumni players. Now, They played at something called Sage Rink until 1949, the Clinton Arena between 49 and 73, the Utica Memorial Auditorium between 73 and 77. Now, their distinct logo, quite nice, you see on the podcast, red, white, and blue with a kind of a ice cream swirl on it. Quite interesting. I would have made the puck a little bit larger, but if you win every year like you did in the 60s, you don't need to show off with your logo. You're showing off on the ice. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you like what we're doing with our vintage podcast on key minor league teams in the States and Canada from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s, let us know with a like, comment, or subscribe. If you have any memories of the team, please let us know. It's good to share. Have a good day. Bye.